And listen carefully as you give your education in journalism.
Opening of knowledge, book of knowledge, the London Somet'ing this.
Just remember this, jungle is not a black thing and it's not a white thing. It's a music thing, a vibe thing, and that's what we want to learn to. You see? Hey! And that's what we want to learn to. Jungle is a
multicolored
thing,
the racial dance.
Just for you.
Just for you,
guys. No, I like it.
Something that they can relate to and something that they can believe in.
I think it's the most forward music around that's being made simply because it's taken the hip-hop beat, combined it with the reggae culture, and it's just a totally new music.
The scene is so underground, it's a word of mouth thing. You know, you tell one person and within 2 weeks everyone knows about it.
Look, 2 years ago when everywhere you went, garage, they say, oh, Arco's dead, Jungle's dead, it's all dead. We carried it, kept it going, brought it to the country, and now they're keeping it going, same way.
Jungle forever.
Definitely London. It's a London thing. I mean, people in people's bedrooms, sitting down with their computers, making music.
You know what type of struggles people go through on the street. You know, and that's mainly street people that go to jungle, people with street cred or whatever you want to call it. At the end of the day, it's all about people that come from an urban background and live, you know what I mean, in communities. Everybody call them working class or whatever, do you know what I mean? But it's definitely from a street level.
No one would really look at the British culture and say, okay, Britain's got his own identification. But, you know, people ignore that and just use it as a dumping ground. Belgium had a lot of influence in the music industry in Britain, saying that they were running it for 2 years, just pumping out their stuff into Britain. And being a Londoner, I said to myself, I had enough of that sort of sound, the wrong direction, bringing us all into somewhere we don't know where we're going. So that's when Ibiza sort of came about.
But it never actually happened like...
It wasn't like all of a sudden it was a jungle club.
Everyone got together and like all of a sudden there was 1,000 jungle records made. It didn't happen like that. It just crept in, and I think the way that it crept in was through Ibiza Records, Reinforced Records. To me, they were the two main people that was creeping at. Paul, definitely Ibiza Records was the first person that started creeping in. Reggae influence, sounds.
And it worked. The sound elements worked. The rugged influence worked. And I said to myself, right, I know what direction I'm going to, because my dad's got untold reggae music sitting at home, you know?
Once the people got the taste of his stuff and they knew that it was working, more people obviously start going to work on it, and it got more and more and more, and all of a sudden the word jungle appears. And
it started with a lot of import, Detroit stuff, hardcore acid. Then it was taken over by the East Londoners to kind of put the breakbeat thing into it. Mix the techno Detroit stuff with hip-hop breakbeats. Then it started getting a little faster, and that's where the changes really come into it.
When we first come into the rave scene, about 1990, it was like, it was all techno stuff. You know what I mean? With a few of the tunes had like a bit of reggae in it, like a little caption from a reggae tune, but most of it was techno stuff, you know what I mean? Hardcore, like foot drums and loads of different psychedelic noises, you know what I mean? It was good, you know, we enjoyed it, but we never used to like rave to it.
The first rave I ever went to was I can't recall the exact name, I think it was called Energy, the rave. but it was in Cambridge. And the Ragatoons took me there. And I can remember being cold, freezing cold, and I just weren't into the music. And I was standing up there and I was screaming at my face. And then one week I went to Astoria. And some DJ was playing and he played this tune, We I Eat, right? And that was it, mate. We I Eat. Seen? That's why you gotta big up man like Lenny the Ice from Arms House Crew, right? Because to me, that tune there was a major influence into the whole of the jungle scene right now. That tune was like
when we came in, we started mixing up the ragga or the reggae with like the techno and the hip hop, and it had a nice sound to it.
Started them scene with the Ragga Twins, but they weren't actually called the Ragga Twins at the time. They were still Demon Rockers and Flinty Badman.
Well, if a prison you are gone,
then go and go serve your time.
And if you're free of that prison,
then don't commit crime.
If a prison you are gone,
then go and go serve your time.
If you're free of that prison,
then don't commit crime.
What happened, Flinty?
What happened, Demon?
A rude boy rock me near my prison. 10 years me get a me, I take it like a man. I may not look no sympathy from no one. Me run this a place from top to bottom, and the navigator him a me right hand man. But Flinty, oh, you look so frightened.
Me no frightened, me a feel what, tension.
What?
Tension? What you talking about?
You see the boy over there, so him eyeball me out.
Oh, him?
Yes, him.
Sure, don't worry. In can't get, take liberty.
Me can't do it, a stick of sense, eh? That is me tension immediately.
Like most of the youths, them, that, like, 2 years ago, you'd have seen in a ragga dance. They're all in the jungle raves.
When you go to jungle raves, you walk in and there's no space to dance. Everyone's in the middle, everyone's dancing, everyone's happy. Because it creates those hyper vibes.
Before we did to ragga, I said to ourselves, the winter rave before, but this is safe. We just came back and did. I don't know, the atmosphere's better, the people.
It's more fun, you get more for your money, basically. That's it.
Booyaka, booyaka, yeah.
Hey, hey, hey. That was a good one, right?
All you can hear is the noise,
Raff
isn't
tune.
It?
Hitch up!
And that means, obviously, if the song is good and it's dropping well, then they want the DJ to stop and start
rewind.
It again. Rewind. And that tune drops and you know what tune it is. Everyone knows what tune it is. Mm. And the buzz is unreal, it is. It's unreal. You can't get another one like it.
That's another reason why I'm involved in the jungle music, because it's brought a lot of people together. You know what I mean? Like certain men, a few years ago, they wouldn't dream of talking to a white person, and the same the other way around. But now, we're all under one roof raving, laughing and joking together.